Welcome to Washington. There is nothing on television like the Fox News Channel. And there is no one in television like Roger Ailes, the 73-year-old Republican strategist and television producer who has been in charge of the channel ever since it launched in 1996. To many on the right, he is a hero. To many on the left, he's an arch-villain. Now, this new book, The Loudest Voice in the Room by Gabriel Sherman, is aiming to be the definitive history of the man. It's been in the works for more than 3 years, and it's been highly anticipated in the media business. And this Tuesday, it's on sale. Now, Ailes did not cooperate with Sherman, but hundreds of other people, including Ailes' older brother Robert, did. Let me read you one of the key passages from the book. Roger Ailes has the power, more than any other single person in American public life, to define the president. For many Americans, admittedly and patently not the ones that voted for him, the Obama they know, the one they are raging against, is the one that Ailes has played a large role creating. Sherman joins me now here in the studio. And Gabe, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
A lot of people have heard this notion that Ailes is the most powerful man in media. But we hear that quote and we hear you describing him as someone who can really get inside our heads and influence the country's perceptions of the president. What led you to those conclusions?
Well, Brian, this, as you mentioned, was 3 years in the making. I talked to more than 600 people to provide this account. It is exhaustive. And what I learned and changed my mind, this process changed me. You know, I've been covering media for a decade. As you've been covering media, you know how Fox is the dominant cable news network. But what I learned is that Roger Ailes has created a political operation that employs journalists. And I'll tell you, it exists for two reasons: to generate as much profit as possible for its corporate parent, Rupert Murdoch, and to advance the personal political agenda of its founder, Roger Ailes.
So you're saying it's a news channel, but it's also a political machine.
No, I'm saying it's a political machine that employs journalists.
So is it a news channel at all in your mind?
I mean, that's for other people to decide.
What about reporters like Shepard Smith?
Of course, that's a great point. You know, there are great reporters at Fox. Shep Smith, Brett Baer, you know, is a sort of hard-charging political reporter, hosts a very, you know, well-regarded news show. But Roger Ailes is smart enough to know that if you're going to give the audience red meat to advance your agenda, you got to give them some nutrition.
Well, I want to, before we go any further, talk about the fact that CNN is a direct competitor to Fox News.
Of course, yes.
Put that on the table. And also talk about an interesting back and forth that happened this week among Roger Ailes and the head of this network,
yes,
Jeff Zucker.
Of course.
I was out at a press conference in Pasadena, California, when Jeff Zucker was asked about Fox. This all started because The Hollywood Reporter had an interview with Ailes where they asked about CNN. They asked about his views of the cable news landscape. He made a comment criticizing CNN for running documentaries. And then Zucker, at this press conference, shot back. He said that comment was just a way to deflect attention from your book. And then he said this, and I want to read this and put this on screen. He said that your book confirms that the Republican Party is being run out of News Corporation headquarters, masquerading as a cable news channel. Now, Zucker also said he had not read the book yet. He'd only read the excerpts that have been online. The book won't be available for a couple more days, but I've read through it, and I'm curious about what you think. Do you think that description from the president of this network is fair?
Well, look, I think Zucker would kill for Ailes' ratings. You know, every executive in TV would. But I think I would put it a little bit differently. Roger Ailes with Fox News has surpassed the GOP. And what I found fascinating after all of my reporting is that this is a vision that Roger Ailes had more than 40 years ago. He gave an interview, which I quote in the book, where he said that he envisioned a day where television would one day surpass the political party as the mass organizer of the 20th century. This was after he had helped Richard Nixon get elected president in 1968. And he saw a day where television was going to move ahead of the political parties. And with Fox News, he has achieved it. You know, inside Fox News, Roger Ailes has disdain for the GOP. You know, he once said to his executives last year that the GOP could not organize a one-car funeral. And the reality is, with Fox News, Roger Ailes has his hands on the wheel, and the GOP is just going along for the ride.
And you're saying that you did not start this book with that belief, that only comes out of the reporting.
Yeah, you know, I've been covering, like, media for a decade, as I said, and I went into this knowing that Ailes has created a phenomenon. Fox News is the dominant ratings. It's the most talked-about news network in the country. And I wanted to explore the secretive world, and I went in, and it took exhaustive amounts of reporting, and I came away with an incredibly different idea. And, you know, it was a testament to Ailes' genius that he has been able to keep the true nature of Fox News secret from the American people for 17 years. And that is a testament to his genius as a political communicator and the power of his network.
I want to go in detail in the next segment about how you reported this book, the process, why so many of the sources are anonymous, but I want to read a comment from Fox before we go any further. They say, aside from Mr. Sherman never interviewing the main subject of his book, both he and your publisher, Random House, refused to submit fact-checking questions to Fox News prior to the book's publication. What do you make of that charge? Were you able to fact check with Fox or with others?
Well, I'll just say this book was rigorously fact checked. I had a team of two fact checkers who spent more than 2,000 hours fact checking this book. I reached out to Roger Ailes more than a dozen times, both in writing and in person, to have him participate in the fact-checking. Ultimately, Roger Ailes and Fox News declined to participate in the fact-checking.
What I was most struck by when I read through the book in the last few days is all of the comments about President Obama and the suggestion that there's real hostility between Roger Ailes and the president. Not that the president feels that way about Ailes, but that Ailes feels that way about him. Mm-hmm. And I want to put a few comments from the book up on screen. The first is this from a former senior Fox producer, an anonymous quote. It says, he honestly thinks Obama has set back the country forever. He feels like he is the only one out there who can save the republic. He has said it. And that implies he said it in meetings, that he's expressed
that? Yes, in meetings.
And then here are three quotes that you attribute to Ailes at various points in the book. Before the president was elected, when he was just announcing his campaign, he's quoted saying, people need to be reminded this guy never had a job. He's a community organizer. Then shortly after he was elected the first time, Ailes is quoted saying, there's no reason to have a civil rights movement anymore since there is a black man in the White House. The third quote that stood out to me was this one. It says, one executive recalled Ailes saying, quote, they hate America. They hate capitalism. Another recalled, he would say, beat the blank out of them. Mm-hmm. Is this a day-to-day theme that you heard about within the halls of Fox, that every day Roger Ailes would talk this way?
You know, I think, Brian, one of the major revelations in this book, and I think the thing that really surprised me and will surprise a lot of your viewers and readers of my book, is that Roger Ailes is more extreme than Glenn Beck.
Well, because some of these quotes sound like things that Glenn Beck would have had said on air. For example, when Glenn Beck said on air something to the effect of President Obama has a deep-seated hatred for white people, you say Ailes agreed with that.
Well, I didn't say that. Sources inside the meetings who heard from Ailes said that after that controversy erupted, Ailes agreed with Beck. And one of the
What makes you think he's more extreme than Glenn Beck?
Because Roger Ailes, one thing that makes Roger Ailes a genius is that he obscures his true agenda. Glenn Beck is transparent. You know, I'll tell you a story that that is in my book. It's a revelation for the first time. Roger Ailes had a conversation only months ago in which he told a politician that if he were president, he had the solution to the immigration problem. And Roger Ailes' solution would be to send Navy SEAL trainees to our southern border and have them find illegal immigrants crossing into the United States, and he would give them direct orders to shoot and kill anyone coming into our country.
And this is from an anonymous source in this case, or is this an on-the-record source?
No, it's an on-the-record source who related this conversation. It's based on contemporaneous notes of this conversation that took place. And Roger Ailes said that to have SEALs earn their certification, he wanted them to have to bring home a dead body.
Let me play devil's advocate with you for a minute.
Sure.
Ailes is a Republican. Everybody knows that. And he's conservative. Everybody knows that.
Sure.
I think we could find other conservatives who would feel the same way he would and would express certain points of view. And I remember many, many years ago, you quote him in the book saying about his relationship with Steve Forbes, one of many Republicans he'd advised. You quote him saying, what I do in my private life is my business, period. Now, do you disagree with that? Does it matter what his personal views are about, say, President Obama or about illegal immigrants?
Of course it matters, and I'll tell you why. You know, I went into this process trying to write a book about Fox News, wanting to write a book about Fox News. I realized very early on into my reporting that the story is not Fox News. The story is Roger Ailes. The network is a complete expression of his worldview. You know, Roger Ailes
said, you're saying it's the Roger Ailes channel.
Yes. You know, Roger Ailes said in an interview several years ago, he said, you know what? I built this network from my life experience. And it's true. In the 8 a.m. meeting and in the regular meetings with his executives, he monologues about his experience with post-war American history, and they absorb his worldview, and everything flows from Roger Ailes and radiates out through that organization. So you cannot write about Fox News, and it does matter what his views are because it ends up on the screen in various forms.
You know, I think about people who write books, they come in with lots of different goals sometimes.
Sure.
What are you trying to accomplish? Because I wonder if people are going to look at this, and if they don't like Fox, they're going to dislike Fox even more. If they love Fox, they're not going to believe a word of what you wrote. Are you going to change any minds, you think?
Well, listen, the number one thing is my mind was changed. I went in simply trying to understand that this is a phenomenon that has changed American culture. And I just wanted to understand how he built both
its
success.
And it sounds like you do have some respect for it, even though you're uncomfortable with some of these comments that he makes.
Incredible amounts of respect. You know, I likened Roger Ailes one time to Steve Jobs, who both are American icons. Steve Apple was a complete expression of Steve Jobs' worldview, and that's why it was so successful. Fox News, very different product, but is a complete expression of his vision. And he is able to marshal thousands of people in to execute his vision. And that takes tremendous talent.
By the way, neither man very often talks to the press.
Very
Steve Jobs was very,